Hello, you wonderful Godot people. Jan here from Canopy Games, and I just want to make a quick little helpful tips tutorial, some things that really help me speed up my workflow in Godot. So whether you're new to Godot, or returning to it, or just want to see if I've picked up anything you've missed, a few things that I hope will be helpful for you. I will, in the description, put in links to some really helpful courses. Some of them are ours, some of them are other people's. I'm not getting paid for the other people's ones. I genuinely think they're helpful courses. So if you want to learn more, I'll put some resources down for you to, you know, see what you can learn. Let's start by making a brand new scene. I'm going to make a 3D scene. And in this 3D scene, I'm going to add, let's say, a kinematic body. We're going to make a player. Now, there's a couple of ways I can do this. First, I can press plus. Great. But I can also press Control A. So I'm going to make a kinematic body. I'm going to rename it player. And I'm going to add in a couple of things. It needs a mesh instance. So let's go mesh instance. Let's Control A again. And a collision shape. So Control A, collision shape. Great. Let's make our mesh instance. So over here on the mesh, I'll press new capsule. That's traditional. And let's rotate this capsule by 90 degrees. So let's go transform. And what angle is that? That is the X. Great. So 90 degrees on the X. There's our player. Lovely player capsule. Okay, to make the collision shape, I'm just going to go collision shape, new capsule shape. And I'm going to rotate that by 90 degrees on the X. Awesome. So here is a very simple little player. I'm just going to move the entire thing up a bit. And we might decide that the player needs to be take up a little less space. So I'm going to have a mesh instance. And I can click on this picture. Every time you've got a little down arrow here, it tells you there's a drop-down menu. So I click here. And we have some things. So let's say I'm going to make a radius of 0.5. And a height of 1 is great. So it's 1 meter tall, half a meter across. It's not human sized, but it might do for our game. Got a collision shape, and I've got these extents. Now, extents always work from radius. So from here, it's great. But what if I had a cube? So let's say I'm going to add a brand new cube. So a new rigid body, let's say. Actually, we'll just do it with a, we'll do a rigid body. Rigid body, great. And let's move you over here. And you need a new mesh instance. So a mesh instance. And a new cube, which is 1 meter cubed. And let's make that smaller. We're going to make you 0.25, so 25 centimeters in all directions. And I'm going to add in a collision shape. So collision shape. And it's a cube collision shape, so a new box shape. And you can see the collision is way bigger than the cube. When I go to extents, if I type in 0.25 here, we've got a problem. Right, the collision is still bigger than the shape because extents are like radius, they're measured from the center. So I actually need half of 0.25, which I think is 0.125. Not a mathematician. Yes, 0.125. Does that fit? I think it does. Let's hide the mesh. Yep, fits great. Okay, so let's take a look at some scripting tips. I'm just gonna get rid of this mesh body for now, so we just got one thing to concentrate on. And let's make ourselves a player script. I'm gonna make a brand new script on player. And we have all this stuff. Some helpful tips. First, what if you can't remember how to use stuff? Now you can go to the Godot documentation. So if I, go to godot.readthedocs.io, you can see the latest documentation and it's all in here. So I could look up, let's say, kinematic body, and it'll search for it, find me kinematic body, and here's everything I need, right? So we have all of the properties, all of the methods, and everything we might need to how to use it. However, alt-tabbing and going online to do this might not work. Maybe you're in a place with no internet connection. Maybe you just don't want to use the real estate on your screen to keep going back to this. You can look up the documentation in Engine. The Engine has the docs. So there's a few ways we can do this. One, I can right-click on the player and go Open Documentation. It's a kinematic body. It's Open Kinematic Body. Here's the docs. I'm going to close that with Control-W. Another thing I can do, let's go back into the script. I can in script view, so you can't see it in 3D, but you can see it in script, you've got search help, and I can type in kinematic body. Same thing again. I can also do this by function. So let's say I've got a physics function, and every frame I'm going to move and slide. And move and slide is a function in Godot. Now I don't have enough arguments here. How do I use this? Well, I can hold Control and click move and slide, and it'll take me directly to the move and slide function within kinematic body. So it's a great way of just looking up something really quick, like what are the arguments for move and slide? There's quite a lot of them. How many are optional? What do they mean, right? What is linear velocity? What is stop on slope? So great way to look up some stuff. Okay, let's not do a move and slide. Let's say, I'm just going to do something very simple. Let's make a ready function. And let's just, I don't know, print hello world. It's going to print it to the console. Fine. Let's say I've got a chunk of code here and I want to duplicate it, right? I can go here and press Control B and it's going to duplicate that line. This is nice if I want to just change a little bit of text in there. I might also have these in the wrong order. Okay, so I can go to a line, hold Alt, and use the up and down arrows to shuffle them. Just to show you how that works, let's just duplicate these a few times with Control B. I am a command line, and I like to walk, I like to go for long walks on the beach. Okay, so right now if I press play, sure, we can save this script, why not? Here we are on the command line, hello world, I'm a command line exactly as we printed. We can move things around, so I can go Alt, up, hello world, I like to go on long walks to the beach, I'm a command line, goodbye world. So we can change the order very easily just by using Alt and up and down arrows. Great way of reshuffling. By that token, if we need to change the indentation, I can select everything and press Tab or Shift and Tab to change the indentation that way. One more thing I would look at is how to use groups and signals. I've seen a lot of people do this in code. There are plenty of times you do want to do that in code. But what if you're setting up a signal that's going to be set up at the beginning of the scene, doesn't have to be set up or changed in code? Can you do this declaratively? Can you do this without having to actually write it out? Yes, of course you can. You've got a node with the body you've got selected. I've got signals. I've got an input event or a mouse entered. Let's say when the mouse enters the player, right? So if you click on the player, I'm going to create a signal. So I'm going to click it here. It must go to a place where there is a script. There is no script on Spatial, but there is on player. You can call it whatever you like. I'm going to keep the name on player mouse entered. Press connect. It's going to create the function for me, and it's already connected. It's connected a signal to itself. You can also do this with group calls. So if I go to groups, I can add this to a group. So I can put PCs and add it, and I can now access this group. So whenever a group call comes in with PCs written exactly like this, the player, this kinematic body, will respond to that group call if it can. So rather than have to do it in code, you can do it over in the inspector, which can be very helpful. Just remember to go back to signal mode, and you can switch back to the inspector here. So hopefully there's some nice little tips to get you started. There's a lot more to learn. There's a lot more this engine can do. So do explore, do play, do watch tutorials and make games and do whatever you can to get comfortable with this engine. I'm going to leave some links down in the description below so you can play with it. Excellent work, and I hope to see you soon.